Can you become better friends in just a few minutes? Well, we're here to find out. This is 36 questions with me, Stian, and joining me today is the star of the Netflix original series Home for Christmas. Hello, Ida.
Hello.
Hello. You're gonna answer the famed 36 questions to fall in love by the psychologist Arthur Aron. And the thing is, it's supposed to provoke deep thought, and we're supposed to learn why you are the way you are. Are you ready?
Yes.
All right, loosey-goosey?
Yes, goosey.
All right. Given the choice of anyone in the world, who would you want as a dinner guest?
Easy. RuPaul Charles.
Oh.
Yes.
Big Drag Race fan?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
This question is kind of strange in this setting, but would you like to be famous?
I didn't come into this world to be famous. That's not why I'm an actress. If I could, it's not like a personal goal. It's never been that, no.
If you could be famous for anything else than acting, what would it be?
Like,
if you could pick and choose?
Easy. Poet.
A poet?
I would love to be a famous poet, yeah.
All right.
I don't think I'm a good one, but that would be great. So romantic, so nice.
I could see you doing that with a fancy hat.
Yes.
A cigarette on, like a big.
Yeah, being all bohemian.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. When did you last sing to yourself?
In the shower.
Like today?
Not today, but I usually sing in the shower.
What are you singing?
I like the old soul divas, so some Etta James there, doing a little soul, doing the grinding, you know, the, huh?
If you, this one's, I gotta keep my tongue straight here, because if you were able to live to the age of 90 and retain either the physical fitness or the sharpness of the mind, your last 60 years, what would you choose? So from 30 to 90.
I'm gonna trick this question, okay? Because I would like to have the mind of a 19-year-old, because they're pretty smart. If you lived on this earth for 90 years, then you're pretty smart. So then I can choose the body.
I think this
you
is.
Understand?
I think you have to choose here. Like, either you look like a goddess and mind is dull, or you're sharp as a whistle and you're,
I want to be sharp as a whistle. I would like to keep my mind, please.
All right.
Yes.
All right. This one is a bit morbid.
Okay.
But do you have a secret hunch about how you're going to die?
Yes.
Do you?
Yes. And it's I hope also I die that way, you know, just fast. I don't know anything. I'm just standing by the traffic lights.
Yeah.
And walking over the street, and then suddenly, because of some tumor in my head. I fainted a lot as a child, so I'm like, I think maybe I should have some damage caused by that.
Knock on wood, let's hope that doesn't happen.
No.
But just a quick one.
Yeah, just a quick
All right.
Death, please.
For what in your life do you feel most grateful?
My family. Mm-hmm. And my friends, my chosen family. I'm also really grateful for living out my dream. I mean, I've always dreamt about being an actress, and I'm doing it now, so that's pretty neat.
That's neat.
Neat.
It is. You ready for this one? Take 4 minutes, it's a long time, and tell your partner, that's me again, your life story in as much detail as possible. And go.
Okay.
Hey.
Can I think? Now is it the
it's rolling.
The world now?
Yeah,
yes. My name is Ida.
Hey.
Elise Broch. My name is Ida because my father was read a story when he was a child that's called Ida's Little Flowers, and he loved that story so much. So he told his mother that he wanted a daughter who would be called Ida. And one day he got a daughter who was named Ida, and that's me. I've always been like this child in her own world. I loved to play and I did it like hardcore. So I had like sessions that were 4 hours or something. Wow. I remember my brain hurting from like I just had to stop because it was so much fun.
It was like imagination overload.
Yes. And with all these figures, I had like, yeah, a lot of small toys and stuff. And yeah, and when I grew up, I kind of, I played with the dolls, but then I think I've become the doll and I'm still like playing, you know?
Yeah.
And I'm still in some kind of living in my own world. And I like that. But maybe sometimes people don't know where to put me in. They don't really understand me.
Yeah.
But I don't care.
Good.
Because it doesn't matter. I mean, what does it matter in the end?
Amen.
Yes. That 4 minutes?
Let's call it 4 minutes. Yeah. Thank you.
Yes.
All right. Tell your partner something that you like about them already.
You?
Yeah.
You're quite charming. You're smart and funny. You're good at your job. You're good to work with. And I feel that I like you, Stian.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Same.
Thank you.
We could become friends.
Yes.
Ready for the last one? And
okay, yes, go.
This one has the kicker. Following the question, 4 minutes of uninterrupted eye contact, soul searching, locked on.
Okay.
All right, you ready? All right, so when I finish the question, we're gonna go. Share a personal problem with me and ask me for advice on how to fix it.
I want to have vacation from myself. I get really sick of myself sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
And Stian, how can I take a break from myself?
Have you tried acting?
Smart. Smart.
No.
Do you have other tips?
Yeah. Video games. Do you like video games?
Yeah, the old ones.
All right. Have you tried the new ones?
Like PlayStation?
Yeah.
Like, so high tech.
Yeah, but that is a good way to have a vacation for yourself.
Okay. Because
you can be another girl or guy in a universe that doesn't exist and do tasks that doesn't exist. Like I use it a lot and I get refreshed after a good gaming session.
Okay. I thought you would say drinking.
Drinking, yeah. That's a very short-term solution. It's not.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm just going for it. All right, you ready to let loose?
Yes.
1, 2, 3. All right.
That's intense. What the fuck?
That is intense. All right, thank you.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you.
It was intense and fun.
Yeah, can we be friends now?
Yes.
Nice. It works. Thank you, hey. Arthur.